So I welcome you to the lecture series on practical machine learning using Python. Now, today our topic is binarization. As the name suggests, this is the technique with the help of which we can make our data binary. And you guys all know that binary means what? Zero or one. For that, we can use a binary threshold for making our data binary. This means the values above that threshold value will be converted to 1 and below that threshold value will be converted to 0. So for the binarization process, we have to select a threshold, and depending on the threshold value, suppose one of our value that is greater than that threshold value will be converted to 1, and say one of our values, means data values, is less than that threshold value will be converted to 0. So the threshold plays an important role in case of binarization. Okay. For example, if we have chosen our threshold as 0.5, then all the values in the dataset above it will become 1 and below this will be 0. That's why we can call it binarizing the data or thresholding the data also, as we are particularly or specially depending on the threshold value. Okay, so this is also known as thresholding the data. The technique is useful when we have probabilities in our dataset and want to convert them into creeps values. Okay, you should note that when will be this binarization technique useful. So I'm repeating again that the binarization technique is useful when we have probabilities in our dataset and want to convert them into creeps value. So we can binarize the data with the help of binarizer class of SkyKit Learn Python library. So binarizer class will be used for this process. And in today's practical session, we will rescale the data of Pima Indians diabetes dataset that we have been already using from the last few lectures. First, we'll load the CSV data. Then, with the help of this binarizer class, it will be converted into binary values, that is 0 and 1, depending on the threshold value. And we have taken, for this practical session, the threshold value as 0.5. Well, so this will be the code. You can take a screenshot of this. Okay, so from pandas import read CSV version function, because this will be used to import our data. And from sklearn preprocessing import binarizer. Okay, binarizer. Do remember this. Okay, that will be imported from sklearn preprocessing. So this is the part where our Pima Indians diabetes CSV file is there. And these are the names of the different attributes. So let's frame data frame using read CSV path. The names will be same as it is, that is names. And let's create an array, that is array is equal to data frame dot values, which have been extracted from this data frame. Now use this binarizer of sklearn preprocessing. So say we have this binarizer is equal to binarizer under bracket threshold is equal to 0.5. Do note that I'm taking 0.5 here. You can take anything that suits to your particular data set. Dot fit array, because our data values inside this array. Got it? This line is very important. Binarizer is equal to capital B-I-N-A-R-I-Z-E-R, binarizer. Threshold is specified as 0.5. And fit array, dot fit array. Okay, so our binarized data will be binarized and be there in the binarizer. So data binarized is equal to binary result dot transform them into array, that is transform array. Now let's print the binary data. So our data will be now converted to binary form, that is they are only in 0 and 1. Let's check that through this print function. So print n binary data n is equal to data binarize 0 to 5. You all know that why I'm using 0 to 5. Okay, can you answer it? So do comment it. So now open your spider. So we have opened our Python IDE and I have written the code as it is what I have just illustrated to you. And I have saved this as the file name binaryresolution1.py. Okay. So you can give any suitable name you want. So let's run this. So the file is running. You can see the output. See, this is the output. So all the values, see, I have specified here. So that's why 5 lines are shown to you. So 5 lines, and there you will see that only the values are in 0 or 1. So guys, you have seen that why we have to use binarizer and how it performs this binarization process. Okay, so I hope this lecture is very much clear to you. So now coming to the today's questions. So today's question is, by what other name this binarization process is known as? I'm repeating again, by what other name this binarization process is known as and why? Okay, so you have to comment the answer, that is the other name of the binarization process and why it is called so. Next question is that which class of this SkyKit Learn Python library will perform this binarization process for you. So you have to comment the class name by which we can perform this binarization process. So guys, I hope you have understood what we have just gone through this binarization lecture. Okay, so don't skip the practical, do it and go through the questions and answer them. Okay, and so stay safe at home and I will wait for your answers. Take care. Bye-bye.